talking about strategies for dealing with performance anxiety. And we're all performers here, but ultimately this can be applied to like anything in your life, whether it be like interviews or, you know, going and giving a presentation like I am right now. And it's gonna be more about like things you can do in your life. I know there are beta blockers and like I take beta blockers, but this is gonna be stuff that you can do while taking beta blockers or besides taking beta blockers. So the first thing is, why do we get anxious? You know, the root of our anxiety. So there are ultimately three different categories of why we get anxious. There are personal causes, task-related causes, and situational causes. So starting with personal causes, there's ultimately just general anxiousness. Like, I'm a generally anxious person. I'm anxious all my life. So getting put in a performance situation, I'm naturally gonna be more anxious. Just because that's how I am. There's the fear of evaluation, just people watching you and evaluating what you're doing, how you're doing. You know, we don't want to be judged, but ultimately we are judged during a performance, whether it be good or bad. History of stage nerves. So you get on stage and you're nervous, that's not just going to stop ultimately. If you have a history of it, it's probably going to continue and you're just going to be nervous all the time. But we can try to combat that. So moving on to task-related causes. These are more of what you're doing. It's not you, it's what you're doing. So the biggest thing is having overly challenging repertoire. You know, you're given this piece and you thought you could do it or your professor thought you could do it, it's just really hard and it stresses you out. And having to perform it for someone is super stressed. Insufficient practice. So hopefully all of us here go and, you know, spend hours in the practice rooms, but, you know, enough time to play on it, you know, have the background of playing it as you should, or you have weak practice skills. I know this is a huge one for a lot of musicians coming into college, is that, you know, we'll spend 3 hours in the practice room, but we're not practicing effectively to get this piece down, and that could be another presentation on itself, so I'm not going to present on that today, but in the future, maybe. And then lack of performance skills, you know, coming in, a lot of us have never really performed in our life. You know, we played in orchestras, maybe played in a couple string quartets, but playing solo is a lot different than playing in an orchestra. You know, even having a solo in orchestra is different than playing in the entire orchestra. So just that lack of performance skills can really get us nervous. And then moving on to situational causes, just difficult circumstances, you know, you're late to the performance, there's traffic, things are crazy at the venue. Just all these things that you can't control but are happening around you that are getting you anxious, so you can't get in that right mental mindset. Public scrutiny, you know, there are people in the audience watching you, and that kind of goes back to the fear of evaluation of people watching you. High degree of concern. So say this is a concert for some big benefit that you could possibly get money for, or a scholarship that you could win, some sort of competition, that sort of thing. And then poor self-care. You know, a lot of things we don't think about is taking care of ourselves before the performance. And I'm gonna talk about this in a little bit later. So, effects. There are three different effects, and a lot of times we think about the at performance or the during performance effects. You know, we're there, we're doing the performance, and that's all we think about. But there are also pre-performance effects and post-performance effects that are just as important. So a lot of pre-performance effects are avoidance of practicing. You don't want to think about it, you don't want to touch it because you're just stressed out. If you avoid it, it'll be fine. Or there's the opposite, which is obsessive practicing. And that's just as detrimental because you're over-practicing and ultimately overworking yourself and also overthinking things and stressing yourself out. You can get headaches, insomnia. I know like the last 2 weeks before my recital, I was not sleeping well. I was having nightmares, you know. And that just ultimately isn't taking care of yourself. And then there's also other things. You can have trouble with relationships. You know, you're being irritable, so you're having problems with your friends, and then that's stressing you out. So it's just this cyclical thing that keeps coming back. And then academic decline and substance abuse, because you just don't wanna deal with things, or you're focusing on this and not dealing with this. So at performance effects are the things that we really think about, and every effect has a cause. So one of my biggest effects is that I get cold hands. I will be as cold as ice. Even now, like, my hands, my fingers, hips are cold. And that's like a sign of confusion, which is kind of weird because I'm giving this presentation. I obviously know what I'm doing, but I'm just like, my body's confused. Why are you so anxious? Cold hands. Because it's keeping all the warmth in your core. Trembling hands is fear. Racing heartbeat, you know, causes memory lapses because your heart's racing so fast. Muscle tension is obviously a big thing, especially in musicians. You want to be loose, and having tense muscles will hurt yourself. Dry mouth, such a big deal, especially if you're a singer or some sort of wind player. You can't have dry mouth. And then post-performance effects are disoriented thinking. So you think back to the performance you just gave, and it will be skewed of, oh my god, I sounded like crap, that was awful, I missed this shift. And when in reality, if you go and watch it, it's probably not that bad. Anger and hostility, you know, people come up and talk to you and you're just angry and hostile towards them because you don't want to talk about your performance or you don't like what they're saying, so you're very combative. It comes back to that trouble with relationships, more academic decline because you're probably thinking about that performance and you don't want to practice again, or you start over practicing because you're thinking about that performance. So it's like all these things that we need to change so that with your mind of think, your mindset is changed, then hopefully your performance will go better. So there's obviously strategies for dealing with performance anxiety. And these go back to what we just talked about, personal strategies, task-oriented strategies, and situational strategies. So starting with personal strategies, the biggest one is just prepare yourself, not only prepare yourself, but take care of yourself. You know, practice, but don't over-practice yourself, especially the day of. You know, don't do a lot of extraneous, really hard activities. You know, you can obviously go practice warm up, you know, play through a scale, you know, play through the pieces once or twice, but like don't go and go rock climbing or something crazy, you know, because you're just ultimately going to put yourself at more stress and tire yourself out. Also, we always talk about just sleep before the performance, you know. Also eat things. I know my recital is at 9 a.m. and so it's like wake up, stress, go to the recital. You know, I didn't eat anything and I should have at least had like a banana, a piece of toast, something really light that will like keep you energized but ultimately will like weigh you down. Another thing is just develop a positive response to stress. You know, every time you start to get stressed, just do something positive, start your positive mind thinking. Especially I get lots of negative mind thinking. You know, I'm gonna miss that shift, I'm gonna play that note out of tune, I'm gonna be late on this entrance because that's how it's been, you know, in the past. I keep doing these things, it's gonna come back and bite me in the butt. But ultimately, if you just push those thoughts away and have that positive mindset, it'll get better and you'll just calm yourself down. A big thing is like physical techniques. So one, to do breathing is like a big thing, or square breathing. So you breathe in for four, hold for four, out for seven, that sort of thing. And just really calm yourself down so that you can really center yourself. Also muscle contractions and releases. So that sounds like it'd be a big deal. Like you shouldn't contract your muscles before your performance, you're gonna get tense. But just like light stretching, like, so you just like sit there and you're just, you know, and just really stretch out your muscles just to really relax yourself and start getting yourself really loose. And then prepare your equipment, materials, and all that logistical stuff the day before. So, you know, have your music already in your bag with your instrument, you know, because that's the thing, you're like, I'm never going to forget my music. It's my music. I'm never going to forget it. You'll forget it, and then you'll stress yourself out. Have all that together. Print your programs before. I know I didn't do this, and I called my brother at 6 a.m. Print my programs. My printer's not working. You know, all these things that we don't think about and then ends up stressing us out because we're just thinking about the performance. So at the task-oriented strategies, choose accessible repertoire. That sounds like really easy. Like, I know what I can play, but ultimately, you know, you don't want to overdo it, and choosing a accessible repertoire can be really easy and help you. Get dressed up. I mean, I dressed up for this because it's like that mental mindset thing. You know, you look nice, you feel nice, you're going to do nice. Warm up and just embody the music. Don't think about it. Just think about what you want to portray through the music and what you want to give the audience. And then, so situational strategies, be acclimated to the performance setting, like just perform in front of people. Whether it be colleagues, your dog, somebody you're really scared of, you know, especially professors. Professors, if you perform in front of them, you know, like they're scary, but ultimately they'll give you good comments and like help you get really into the performance setting. And then what I really like to do is when I get to the venue, assume a backstage mode. So you're there, your stuff's there. Not just like holding an inner smile, even if you're like just sitting there and you're like kind of deadpan face, just having that inner smile inside of yourself. And then just really move and speak calmly, because if you feel calm and you portray calm, and you'll be seen as calm. Be mindful of your breath, obviously, going back to that 1-2 breathing. Minimize extraneous speech. Don't really like talk to people that you don't need to talk to. You know, somebody wants to come up and start like talking about last night's football game, be like, that's cool, I'll talk to you later about it, thank you. And then like go on. And then just foster that desire to performance. Think about how you want to perform for people. So, any questions?
So you mentioned that one of the most, like a really effective way of dealing with it is not picking a piece that's too hard. Mm-hmm. What if you're just beyond that? Like, what if it's too late to go back, essentially? Like, how, what would be the next most effective way to approach? Yeah.
I think it would be going back to that, like those personal, like inner strategies of the positive thinking and starting to get yourself centered, and just moving past any mistakes you make. You know, I think if you're already past that point, you can't go back and dwell on it. So just keep moving forward and just use that if the performance goes well or bad. You know, use it for the future, because ultimately, you know, whatever happens, there will be another time to make up for whatever.
So you talked about like kind of like what at performance anxiety looks like. What are like strategies if like say like, because like when you have to play like multi-movement pieces and you're not like leaving the stage, but you like, I feel like it's a different, it's kind of like a, it requires different strategies. Like what are some strategies that you can do if you're like already on stage but you're like anxious and like all over?
I think between movements, just take a breath and recenter yourself. Like one of the things is I started off with my end pin too long when I started my box. So after the prelude, you know, I sat there, you know, adjusted it myself, then centered myself, and just take that like, you know, 2-second break, you know, or even longer, you know, however long you need to like really feel yourself again, you know. So just take a break. Have water on stage. I mean, no one's gonna yell at you, even though we're string players, to have water, you know. So if you need to take a drink of water, take a drink of water.